sign language, facial expressions can be used to express linguistics information and emotion. For example, eyebrow raise is used to mark general questions in most sign languages. Unlike handshakes, which are often very different from one another, facial expressions are often very similar, and humans have evolved to detect minor changes in expression. In sign writing, there are 6 main facial components: the forehead, the eyebrows, the eyes, the cheeks, the nose, and the mouth and tongue. And as there is no dataset that contains these classes, at least as far as I'm aware, I'll have to create one myself.
So, here's my idea. Because faces are very different depending on age, gender, and race, it will be very hard to collect data from existing pictures. Instead, for each feature, I want to come up with a function that takes a face and adds that specific feature, like a smile or a frown. I took a few shots of my face, trying to control for the various features, and encoded them using StyleGAN. The idea is that by comparing a picture of a neutral face with a picture of a smiling one, I can find the direction of change that would generalize to other faces. Unfortunately, StyleGAN doesn't really like my face. Perhaps it's because of the lighting or lack of symmetry. Who knows?
Luckily, I have a backup plan. But first, there's something I need to do.
I'm now in Zurich, Switzerland, working on an unrelated sign language project with the University of Zurich. But back to this project, let me explain what my current approach is. Earlier this month, a new paper titled StyleClip, Text-Driven Manipulation of StyleGAN Imagery, was published, which allows to basically manipulate images using freeform text. I think this can be really helpful for us, as we can generate images of faces in different kind of configurations, whether their eyebrows are raised or not, their eyes big, small, closed, open, the mouth smiling, frowning, or any other shape. We'll just need to see how well we can generate these images. Now, because the authors of this paper are truly amazing, they released a Google Collab notebook where one can demo their work and instantaneously create new images of different configuration of faces, for example. I went over the SignWriting non-manual features guide and try to create images using different prompts that would conform to these features. Let's look at an example. We always start with a source image. In this dataset, we loaded 2000 different images and then applied different features on top of them. You can see that while these features change, other features remain constant. This is really good for us because now we can run the face mesh model on top of each of those images and train a model to predict the features in each one. Because the face doesn't change too much, we can also create an asymmetric picture by combining half the picture that has eyes open with half the picture that has eyes closed to generate a picture with a wink, one eye open and one eye closed. Unfortunately, as you can see, the face mesh model doesn't really capture the eye aperture really well, and for closed eyes, it says they're a bit open. I'm hoping that the model can generalize on top of that, but if not, we'll have to wait for a better face mesh model. Now that we have the data, one step before training a model would be to do some data normalization. A face can come in different orientation, for example this, that, or this, and can be of different size. We want the face normalized in order to remove all these degrees of freedom and make the classification easier for the model. We define a plane using 3 points, the tip of the nose and these 2 points on the eyes. We then move this plane to be lying on the XY plane, so the face is looking a bit down. Next, if the face was tilted a bit to the left, a bit to the right, we rotate the face such that the middle of the forehead and the tip of the nose both lie on the Y axis. Finally, we move the tip of the nose to the center point, 0, 0, and scale the distance between the nose and the middle of the forehead to be of constant length. I hope this neutralizes all the degrees of freedom in human face movement without removing any necessary information. Now, let's train a model. Alright, so now we have this model running in the browser. It's a multi-class, multi-label classification, meaning that it's the same model who's predicting the eyes, the eyebrows, and the mouth all at once, and each of them have multiple possible labels. Let's turn on the draw SignWriting, and now we see some things on my face. Maybe we'll turn off the pose, and then we'll see that there is a mouth. The mouth is just open, nothing. If I can smile, then it smiles. If I raise my eyebrows, they're raised. If I lower my eyebrows, they're lowered. If I close my eyes or blink, then they're closed or blinking. Open eyes wide, maybe works a bit. If I yawn, then it's so weird because I'm drawing the symbol depending on the width rather than the height. So, and yeah, if I smile, it kind of works. Smile with closed mouth, maybe. Doesn't work that well, but at least the eyes, the eyebrows are caught pretty well, in my opinion. And when I'm speaking, then you can see that the mouth is moving. Right now, there are 4 categories for the eyes, 3 categories for the eyebrows, and 7 categories for the mouth. But SignWriting does have many, many more. So future work on this is required. And also this was trained to predict a symmetric result, meaning that both eyes are closed, both eyes are open. There is no situation where one is and one isn't. And future work should address that, as well as adding more labels to each class or add more classes, requiring maybe if we need to know the state of the ears or the cheeks or the nose. The pose estimation doesn't even have a tongue to it. So if I put my tongue out, there is no actual distinction on the pose. So maybe also future improvements in the face mesh will definitely improve this model and this work. But for now, this is what we have. So this is what we'll do. And of course, we can also just turn all the video off and just see the SignWriting. Now we can see that really the eyes and eyebrows are overlapping each other, but that's because they are very close in physical space. If I turn around maybe, then you can see that the face kind of does turn around, which is cool because everything is tied to its actual position. If I raise my eyebrows or lower them, you can see the effects. And yeah, I think this is it. All right, so this is it for today. Thank you so much for watching if you got this far. If you want to try the data creation code or the model training code, you can find them down in the description, as well as link to the playground where you can actually try this yourself. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.